In the previous lecture, I explained you about general structure of any assembly language program. Now I will tell you how to execute your assembly language program with the help of Turbo Assembler TASM. If you have Borland C compiler installed on your system, you can run your assembly language programs. So if you see, you go to start and run, and in the run you have to type CMD, so command prompt will be displayed. Before executing these steps, you have to make sure that your program is typed in the notepad and stored with an extension .asm. So the following four commands you need to type to execute your assembly language program. So first one is path. You are giving this command, path is equal to /borland/c/bin. So what this command is doing means, it is telling your DOS where your assembly language program tools are placed. So they are in C drive under the folder Borland C, under the folder binaries. So all the tools you are using to execute your assembly language program, like TASM, T-Link and TD. These three are called the tools used to develop your assembly language program. These three tools are under this binaries folder, and it will tell the path to the DOS. And next command is TASM. This is a Turbo Assembler file name .asm. For example, you saved your program as add1. So you have to give TASM space add1.asm. So this assembler will assemble this add1.asm file. So assembler will take the ASM as the input file, and it will give the object file as the output file. And if there are any syntax errors present in your program, those errors you can identify with the help of Turbo Assembler. So assembler gives you the syntax errors. And the next tool you use is T-Link. So this will take object file as the input file, and it will give the executable file as the output file. So what is the use of this linking means, in actual real time programs, they are big programs you have to write. So instead of writing a single big program, programmers will divide that big program into small modules, and they will generate one object file for each and every module, and finally they will combine all those modules into a single module, and they will generate a single object file. So linker is used for that purpose. So it will take the object file as the input, and it will give the executable file as the output. And the last tool you are going to use in your program development, assembly language program development, is Turbo Debugger. So Turbo Debugger space file name .exe. That means if your program name is add1, so you will give input file as add1.exe to the Turbo Debugger, and it will give you the running instance of your program, that is binary file you are going to see. So what is the use of this debugger means, you can identify the logic errors with the help of debugger only, and you can change the values, and you can see the results, and you can modify the variable values, and you can dynamically see the results with the help of this debugger. And logic errors means, for example, if you have written program for addition operation, and if it is giving you the subtraction result, that type of situations you can identify only with the help of debugger only. So syntax errors are, if there is any syntax error present in your program, you can identify those syntax errors with the help of assemblers. And if any logic errors are present, you can identify those logic errors with the help of debuggers. So this is all these are the necessary tools required to run your assembly language program.